Hi, I'm Doug, your tech support representative for Atlantic British, and as part of our service and maintenance kit program, we're going to show you the kit that you would be receiving for your tune-up segment on your Defender 90. Now, that's going to be kit number G. Part number is, or kit number is 9207, and you'll be receiving our most popular spark plugs cable set. These are cut to match the same length as the original equipment, also pre-numbered so you know what cylinder to go on, and a full set of Champion spark plugs. In a few minutes we'll show you how to install that on your vehicle. Okay, so now we're going to give you the basics on the installation for the spark plug wire and spark plug tuning kit. This is kit 9207. This is for the 97 D90 with the 4-liter GEMS engine. Now, if you're not sure whether you have GEMS or Bosch, which you wouldn't have a Bosch engine in the Defender, but there are other models that would have both, you can go to our previous videos and our friend Jim will show you what the difference is between the GEM and the Bosch engines. So, what we're going to do on this essentially, and this is relatively easy, if you've ever changed spark plugs, these have the 13/16 head plugs. All right, these are not the smaller 5/8. I usually recommend, because I've noticed that a lot of these plugs, they don't come with the cardboard protection anymore. Before you install a plug, you always want to check the gap. Take 10 seconds now to save yourself a half an hour later. And it's nothing more than a relatively inexpensive gauge. You can get these at any automotive center. One side will have it broken down into fractions of an inch. The other side will be metric. In this case, they actually give you an English version of the gap, which is 0.033 to 0.038. So you just want to slide that over and up. Now you can see we're actually a little on the high side right here. So you want to just give it a tap, knock it down a little bit, and now we're at 0.037, which is perfect. We're within the range. So now we can install this plug. Okay, so we're going to show you how to change a plug and put your spark plug wires in. Now, change the plugs. I usually find that if you haven't done this on a regular basis, you're going to just do this one cylinder at a time. It's much easier. Now, on this particular engine, the 4.0 and the 4.6, the cylinder location is going to be the same on both. And you're going to have your even number cylinders on the right-hand side, which would be 2, 4, 6, and 8. And your odd number cylinders on the driver's side, 1, 3, 5, and 7. Now, what's nice about these sets, and actually even the original equipment wires, will be marked with the number cylinder that they correspond to. So when you take this apart and doing one at a time, you can remove your spark plug, you know what number cylinder you have, trace your wire back, there's your location on the coil, remove that one wire, and then when you're done changing the spark plug, reinstall your new wire with that corresponding number. And then you're just going to do each one all the way around. We have our 13/16 swivel head socket, long extension. Our spark plug is off, our spark plug wire. We're going to slide this down, hook up to the plug. Now this one may come out reasonably easy. We actually just recently put plug wires and plugs in this vehicle. But you're going to put a little arm behind it. Now, if you don't have the swivel head socket and you don't have the long extension, you can get down in there with a ratchet, a regular straight socket, spark plug socket, and a short extension. And fortunately on these, there's quite a bit of room to get down in there, so you'll have plenty of room to work. Now again, I'm going to keep reiterating, being this is a Defender, you don't want to be setting anything down outside of this mat, and definitely nothing heavy on top. These aluminum fenders can imprint. Now, there's essentially our plug. This is a relatively new plug, but if you're doing spark plugs on your vehicle, now's a good time. Read the plugs. It'll give you a good idea as to how your vehicle is running. We got a nice even tan burn. We got a little bit of carbon built up, which is normal, but no heavy soot and no bright white porcelain, which would tell you you're running lean. No heavy soot that'll tell you you're running rich. This is a good running plug. Now, as I said, we just recently put plugs in this, so we're going to put this spark plug back in. But I'll show you a nice little trick, just in case it gets a little awkward, and I found this works exceptionally well on vehicles with tight space. This is a piece of 3/8 heater hose. Basically, 4 or 5 inches. You can actually use a much longer piece if you want. but it fits just right over the porcelain of the plug. This gives you a little bit extra reach. Feel around, you feel the plug settle into the hole. Because trying to get your fingers down in there where the spark plug is could be a little tight. And you'll feel it, it'll drop right in. And just simply spin the hose. Plug will thread in. Now in this case, this is threaded in fairly easy because, as I said, this is all new. This is a fairly new plug. You can wet the end of this, your new spark plug a little bit. You can put a little drop of penetrating oil or whatnot on there so that it threads in all the way. And you'll feel it when the plug stops turning. Simply pull the hose back off. Slide your socket back on. Reset your ratchet. And you'll feel it when it comes to a stop. And then just give it a little quarter turn, if that, maybe an eighth of a turn. You'll feel it seat in. You don't want to over torque. These are aluminum heads. You don't want to take the threads out of the heads. Now you've had your spark plug wire off. You know where your location is. You're going to slide your new wire back up in place. You spin back and forth a little bit and you'll feel it seat in. Same with the spark plug end. And I've actually found on some of these it's nice if you have some dry silicone spray. Just give it a little shot of silicone because it won't become a conductor for the electrical charge that's going to be sent to the plug. But it will make putting that boot on the plug a lot easier. And you'll feel it seat in. You just wiggle back and forth and you'll actually feel it drop in place. Clip your wire back up into your routing looms. Now you're ready to move on to the next spark plug, and you're going to do the same thing all the way around. And when you're done, you'll have a new set of wires, new set of plugs, and you should actually see a little increase in your fuel economy. Hey, so if you're ready and you feel you're ready to do a spark plug and cable tune-up on your vehicle, remember we have that kit, and this is now on our new service and maintenance academy. You can call any of our knowledgeable salesmen. They'll be happy to help you out. You can call at 1-800-533-2210.